pues supe que fue ella. I'd seen a lover cover a stranger's breasts in his bed I made warm. In his mama's house, I used to feed family in. And set it as a profile picture to tell me he didn't fuck her. I know that poison in your belly to believe in your mind. Find and ears and a pill. I know the sting of rape. And I know your judgment on that as well. I've grazed the cold apathy of flesh in a coffin and the red hot swish of welt and wet salt crystallizing on your lashes. I watched my folks take a loss on 35 years of vows, that sweet three-digit Asbury abode. I know picking up the man I loved with a nail through his forearm, missing $2,000, and the instant the terror set in, knowing his demon might never release me as well. I know watching a man grab his wife in a cheap plastic tile kitchen and toss her, the full dimensions of her soaring above my child eyes, crouched in a corner screaming, please stop. Please don't hurt her. And in the background, my mother's voice wailing for my protection. The men rushing in and so many fists. I know a surgeon standing over my 8-year-old deathbed telling me I had zero choice in the entire matter. From the moment he would sever my right iliac vein until the 40 danger zone days for DBT during COVID, while you were fucking her on a beach somewhere. I wish I'd just known. I wish I'd just known. You said, I always want to see you, the whole of you, the sweaty, the dirty, the messy, the sacred, and the scared. I'm not going anywhere. And you said it holding me while I caved into your chest on bended knee. Did you know that I bowed before God and a priest once? You said so many sacrilegious, shitty things like that. Like I was the woman you prayed for. And it was not the beautiful fallacy that you had plans for me. It was not demanding I say I love you. It was not demanding I say you were my man. It was not giving you my body. It was not bearing my raw fucking soul into the walls, into the spirit of the green backyard chairs, the bath towel you took and never gave me back. It was not regretting all the times you told me that you had cried, that you tried to mend an old relationship, that you healed a fractured conversation, that you conversed with God and needed to be held. And I did. In silence. It's not regretting growing to care deeply for your skin, its scent, but also your kin, simply because they were your blood and it was my honor. It was not regret that I humbled myself as a woman as best I knew how. I told you about my mother. I told you about my struggles. And I said I wanted to learn. I did the best that I could. It was not regret that you cheated mentally, probably, with your escape plan before you physically did it. It's that you made me believe you into existence as a message from God and destiny. But somehow, you made me hate every good thing I had celebrated about myself in your eyes. But she does so much more than all the things you got down on me for. I wish that right click had never come through and I could blip you out of existence the way you did my essence from the pink of your lips, the tip of your smooth dick, and the first number you want to dial in the morning. Now I believe in a darker kind of magic, a divine feminine more erotic than the garbage astral promises your psychedelic words and sex promised. Empty bullshit that sat on my chest. I hope she loves your mama, your moods, your rage, and your fears. The past, the not so distant Jekyll and Hyde. I know that you know you can be. That you're just as capable of being as cruel to her as well. It's the insidious. I regret that the fucking most of all. You are insidious.